Blackstone Publishing presents Belle Isle, A Willie Black Mystery by Howard Owen. This book is read by Kevin Kenerly. To Karen. Chapter 1. Saturday, October 20th. The phone vibrates inside my pants pocket. I figure it's just another call about the 1 billionth soliciting my vote in the upcoming can't-be-over-soon-enough elections. Then the name comes up on the tiny screen. McGonagall. R.P. McGonagall doesn't call very often, and I'm going to see him tomorrow anyhow. What? I answer pleasantly as Cindy scowls at my phone etiquette. R.P. sounds out of breath. Dude, he says, I'm over at Belle Isle. He stops to catch his breath. Like me, my old Oregon Hill buddy could profit from more exercise or less nicotine. There's something over here you gotta see. It's a leg. Somebody's leg. What I finally get from my old friend is this. A couple of kids, canoodling in the woods above the river, stumbled across a human leg, or at least the bottom half of one, up in the bushes. Nothing else? I ask. Just the leg. You sure it's human? Unless deer are wearing shoes these days. R.P. assures me that the rest of the body apparently is elsewhere. They've called 911, but I thought you want to know. Might make a story. Yeah, no shit. It's just past 1 o'clock, 2 hours before my shift starts at the Word Factory. The temptation is to pass R.P.'s information on to Chuck Apple, who's on from noon till 8 tonight. But I'm intrigued, and Belle Isle is just down the hill from my old neighborhood. A leg? Cindy asks. Yeah, not much doubt. R.P. said it still had a shoe attached. Which one? Huh? Which leg? I wonder aloud what difference that makes. I don't know. I didn't ask. Cindy sniffs. Some reporter. So I haul my ass off the comfy couch I've been sharing with my sweetie and head off for Belle Isle. I call Sally Belez, my editor, and tell her what I'm up to, in case the damn police radio is actually on and she sends Apple. Probably a fatality, I say. Won't count until they find the rest of him, her, whatever. I'm able to get a parking space along the overlook on the north side of the James River. The early morning rain has stopped, and it looks like it's going to be a nice day, except maybe for the chump who's missing a leg. From the overlook, it's a steep and slippery climb down to where the pedestrian bridge leads over to the island. My deck shoes aren't what I'd have chosen to wear if I'd given it a little thought. I see the emergency vehicle parked in the lot below, and am thankful that I only have myself to transport over to the island. I'm sure the EMT folks are hauling everything over there, just in case the rest of the body's in the vicinity and somehow still has a pulse. Fat chance. But you gotta try. There aren't many other people on the footbridge today. As I walk across to Belle Isle, I can see the herons down below, waiting on the rocks for dinner to swim by. You can even see an eagle down there once in a while, enjoying a little sushi. When I get across, I see a pack of the morbidly curious have gathered at a place not too far uphill from the path leading around the island. And in the middle of it are the usual folks who show up to officiate over mayhem in our city, the EMTs, the cops, and even a couple of firemen for some reason. I look for McGonagall, but he's apparently already departed. One of the cops on the scene is Gillespie. The porcine Chauncey Gillespie is one of the few city policemen who still is on speaking terms with me, as long as I don't call him Chauncey. Understandable. It's still hard for me to believe that they ever let a guy named Chauncey into the police academy. I ask him what's going on. He looks around to make sure the chief or anyone else with authority over him isn't around before he answers. Kid's found a leg, he says. I know what kind of leg, but it's fun to fuck with Gillespie. What kind of leg? Chicken leg? Leg of lamb? He hitches his pants up over his sizable belly. Human leg, asshole. They found some guy's leg up there on the trail. How do you know it was a guy? He grunts. Well, if it was a woman, she sure had hairy legs and big feet. The rescue squad people are combing the area around where they found the severed limb. I look over in the shade, and they put a tarp over what I assume is the leg. Another cop is talking to the two kids who found it. I slip past the cop and his interviewees and reach down to sneak a peek under the tarp. Hey, the cop says, get away from there. This is a crime scene, Black. Get your ass away from there. A quick glance was enough. I see lots of dead bodies in my...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.